Stakeholders in the coffee sector have welcomed the recently passed European Union deforestation regulation that seeks to encourage more farmers to plant trees rather than cut them to pave way for growing coffee. The new directive is aiming at limiting global deforestation and forest degradation provoked by the EU consumption and production. The EU deforestation regulation imposes strict rules in terms of due diligence to all companies wishing to place affected products on the European market or export them. Speaking during a meeting in Kampala under the theme Securing the Future of Africa's Coffee Trade, Jane Nalunga, the Siatini Uganda Executive Director, noted that the discussion was timely to devise strategies to support the coffee sector.
The EU deforestation directive is very, very important for our coffee sector in Uganda here, because what EU is telling us is that we need to show them that when we are growing our coffee, we haven't cut down any forests. So it's up to us to be able to show that evidence. And they are looking at the years from 2020. From 2020, how did we plant our coffee? So that's really a very difficult task, because each farmer has to be mapped that my farm is so big and this is how I have planted my coffee.
Nalunga says there is a need to sensitize farmers who are to be affected by the new directives.
The most farmers are not aware of, some are aware, but most of the farmers are not aware of what's going on. And maybe what my appeal to the media, like you, the media, is to be able to put this message across. Because what we also see is that there is a lot of distrust among farmers. When they tell them that we need this information, we need to do this, some farmers are distrustful that maybe they want to, government wants to tax them, which is not true. So we need a lot of awareness. We need the farmers to understand the gravity of the issue, and I think the media can play a key role.
The regulation will apply even-handedly to products from both inside and outside the EU region. Producers will need to engage in sustainable production practices and improve supply chain transparency.
The other aspect coming from that declaration is building the capacity of the private sector to be more productive and to be more responsible and to be more sustainable in managing the coffee sector. Then the other one is partnership between the African Development Bank and then the other players, YACO, in mobilizing funding to enable these activities to be achieved.
Of course, as we are going back, we are going to tell them, we are going to stress them, to do what we call to do afforestation, planting more trees, replacing those ones which they have cut, because those, as they cut them, these coffee trees need a shade. So we are to argue them to plant more trees.
The EU is stepping up its engagement with the partner countries, consumer and producer countries alike, with the aim of collaborating to reach common objectives as agreed under the Sustainable Development Goals, the Paris Agreement, and in the Global Biodiversity Framework, and also to stimulate continued sustainable trade between partners.